Welcome back, Aces, to another X-Wing Battle Report. Today it's Sam versus me.
Alright, today Sam is playing Vader with Predator, Advanced Targeting Computer, the Title, TIE X-1, and Engine Upgrade, as well as Shirno with Callus, Palpatine, Expose, and Experimental Interface.
And then I am running with Poe with the R5P9 Astromech, Auto Thrusters, Push the Limit, Jake Farrell with Auto Thrusters, Proton Rockets, the A-Wing Test Pilot Title, Veteran Instincts, and Push the Limit, and a Gray Squadron Pilot with the R3A2, the Stress Bot, and TLT.
Stress Bot, I was afraid whenever I see Stress Bot on the board. He's so annoying.
Yeah, I like the Stress Bot a lot. I don't feel like it's necessary to run the Y-Wing title with it. I mean, now you only get one stress with the TLT on it, which kind of sucks, but it's nice being able to dish out at least one extra stress. It screws up most things that have pushed the limit, and I don't feel like you really need to put two stress on something all the time.
Yeah, I really think that things with push the limit already have stress on them, at which point another stress really kind of screws them. And things that don't, you know, they're more accustomed to not having actions anyways, so...
Yeah, I found a lot of aces really don't have a problem arc dodging one stress bot for one Y-Wing. It's really easy to get out their arc, and being able to make full use of your TLT really helps out a lot.
And here we see a very aggressive move by Shirno, just racing up the board like that. But with Palpatine and Callus and Expose at range 1... of the target for Callus, it's probably going to result in some serious pain.
Yeah, I kind of expected him to be a little more reserved with Shirno. I didn't expect him to just kind of YOLO in there, but I mean, it's a really strong strategy. I mean, he's still a decimator. He doesn't. He cares about getting damage and getting crits on him, but not as much. I mean, he doesn't really have any of the survivability that I usually use on Shirno. So I was just kind of surprised that he went that aggressive with them, and I mean, Poe's going to be taking 5 dice with a lot of modification here.
Well, without that survivability, there's no reason for a decimator to hang back like that. All it does is make the other guy stronger and have a better time dealing damage.
Yeah.
So you might as well get up in there, do as much damage as you can, knowing that you're going to take some hate anyways.
Yep. And Vader getting some working on the Y-Wing right away.
Yeah, I think it's interesting that he chose to maneuver Vader towards that Y-Wing. It's clear that it really has such an effect on, the instincts of players, because, as we'll see, you know, with all that damage, we really could have had a very dead Poe if he'd chosen to move Vader up into range.
Poe dodging one there, he's still taking 2 hits and 2 crits, and the first crit's double damage.
Yeah, that's terrifying for any Poe, and imagine
that's
that...
That's a sad Poe in an opening shot.
Imagine if Vader had taken 1 or even 2 shields off before this attack, Poe would be very dead, and this would be a serious blow to anyone's list.
Oh, yeah.
I think we're going to see some stress bot action, but...
Yep, getting a double stress on Shirno. Trying to knock down as much of his damage ability, I guess, as possible.
Yeah, I think it's an interesting choice. I almost think that, it's a difficult choice. Callus really sits in the place where Predator would normally sit, so I think Expose is an alright EBT to take, but... Under normal circumstances, I think I'd favor more of a passive ability to roll, re-roll dice than kind of active ability to get more dice.
Yeah, at the start of the game, I remember questioning him why he would put Callus on Shirno. I mean, you get to flip 2 focuses out, but I guess with your experimental interface, you're just always going to be target lock and expose, and being able to get 2 focus modifications on a single ship, it turned out to be a lot stronger than I expected it to be.
That's certainly a very strong ability. And experimental interface is a weird modification. You don't see it as often as you would think, considering that it's basically a kind of like a different PTL.
Yeah.
I think it's because there's not as many actions, action cards that you can really rely on.
Yeah.
Your devastating asteroid interference for Vader. You always feel bad when you see someone land on an asteroid.
And taking a shield out on top of it.
Ugh. Terrible.
Jake going up, trying to keep pressure on Shiranu. Looks like he might bump here. Yep, that's going to be a bump.
That's unfortunate. Anytime you can't take shots, especially on the big guy. But, looks like he's got arc on Vader, who will not be taking shots, and is in a uniquely vulnerable situation.
Oh, right, yeah. It's not a happy Vader.
Jake is an interesting pilot. He's so maneuverable like Fel, but he lacks a lot of that offensive power. I see a lot of people...
Yeah, no, I love his ability. Getting a focus and being able to boost or barrel roll off of it is really solid. It really turns him into just a different Fel. Something that I find myself wanting in most of my Rebel lists is just a really strong arc dodger, somebody who can get in there and dish out damage. Most of the time you see him with Shard and Refit, but I like the Proton Rockets. I think in this three-ship build, I like the extra damage output.
Anytime you can afford Proton Rockets, you should go for it. I mean, it's such a great card, and it works off of A-Wing so well, especially Jake. You're really going to see that range 1 focus shot a lot more often than you might with other A-Wing pilots. But, I mean, Chardon is good for obvious reasons. I suppose if you're not going to pay the points to take Proton Rockets, there really is zero reason not to take Chardon Refit.
And that R5-P9 doing work for Poe, keeping him alive and keeping him kind of in this fight.
Yeah, regenerating Poe is really one of the most devastating things you'd see, along with regenerating Corran Horn, obviously. They just sort of break off from the fight and then come back with full shields. It's really unfortunate, especially if you haven't actually managed to get any damage on their call through.
Yeah. A lot of times you see Poe with veteran instincts, which is really strong. It's solid, but I prefer it with Push the Limit. I like to make full use of that boost that the T-70 gets. I feel it's a little bit better than bumping up to Pilot Skill 10.
Well, I really feel like with Poe, you're already kind of at an action economy disadvantage because you really want to take the focus every single turn. And that really actually limits your options because, I mean, Poe without a focus is a very, like, vulnerable Poe, so you're not utilizing your boost or your target lock nearly as often as you normally would be, considering how useful those two actions are. With Push the Limit, you really get use out of them.
Yep. And here we're seeing that ridiculous dice modification on that Y-Wing, getting two crits through. Looks like double damage, and looks like at the start of every combat round, he's going to be rolling one attack die.
That's rough for a Y-Wing. It looks like a TLT reply back on Vader. That's pretty devastating. But looks like he lives.
Yeah, getting one in there. Vader down to one hull, still parked on an asteroid.
Gotta feel bad for him.
And then Wyoming trying to clear some of his stress, trying to get rid of that crit eventually. Shiranu clearing up his stress, going to be able to target lock expose again.
Yeah, that's rough, being able to do that every turn. And then, of course, sometimes it can take a long time for Poe to sort of get back into the fight when he disengages like that, which I think is kind of the advantage that Corran has.
Yeah, it's not the worst for Poe, especially in this situation. As damaged as he is, he wants to be out of the fight for a little while.
Yeah.
Get those shields back up, and Jay can stay in there and keep the pressure up, and he's not going to have too much of an issue with Shiranu. Unfortunately, it looks like he's going to be taking 5 dice here, but still got those Proton Rockets. Going to offload that for sure.
And with a serious chance of doing some nasty crits onto him with no defense dice, because it looks like he's exposed again. It's gonna be pretty painful.
Yeah, well, he's only got 2 damage on him, so he can take 5. But I mean, you get several lucky crits in there. I've seen it happen before. Pull up 2 or 3 double damage in a row. But
Well, there's. I think that's the great thing with the new deck is there's just so many great options. I mean, there's so many great crits in the deck. They all kind of hurt. So right now, nobody wants to see a crit whatsoever. We have lost a TLT.
Palpatine got that last hit, making the dead Y-Wing. It's not a bad choice.
Expensive, though.
Five dice on the proton rockets.
Ugh.
So many symbols.
It looks like at least five hits.
Four and a crit.
Oh, that's painful.
And the crit is Blinded Pilot. And that's just a sad Shiranu.
That's about the most perfect thing that could happen, really. No dice back. Oh, it's really painful to see that. And here it looks like Sam made a slight tactical error. He forgot that he exposed and pushed and did the experimental interface to do that.
Yeah,
so he keeps his stress. Can't quite pull off the combo again.
He was going to be in a bad spot if he did a two bank there anyway, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, right now, sure, I think this is kind of exposing the real weakness of this list, is if you can kind of get an alpha strike and do a lot of damage on him, it's really hard for him to recover, loses a lot of the durability, reduces itself pretty fast, and now he's hurting and he really wishes he could.
And Shiranu Vader can certainly dish it out in the first couple of rounds. I think they're at a severe disadvantage if they can't remove a ship in the opening shots.
Yeah. Yeah, like I said, if Vader in that opening round had gone in on Poe, I really think there may have been a dead Poe.
Oh yeah, certainly. And Jake getting his range one in there. Looks like just a focus and a target lock.
That's all you need.
Three damage left on Shiranu. He's got a solid chance of taking him out here.
Yeah, that's the risk of these two ship builds is, you lose one of your ship, that is half of your fleet, regardless of how much those ship costs. And yep, there goes Chernow, and now it's a one health Vader versus a Poe with one hull and three shields.
Yep.
And a full health Jake. That's not a good position.
Yeah, and I lucked out with the initiative too on that one, so I got Jake moving after Vader, so I got that movement advantage.
I can't tell you how many games I've won because my opponent won initiative and then decided to keep it when they had same pilot skills. With really maneuverable ships, I think you really have to give up the initiative because you need to see where the other guy is going, otherwise he will arc dodge you.
Oh, certainly. Initiative is huge in this game, especially with the top ace lists that are so strong right now in the meta.
Yeah, and with someone like Fel or Vader or Jake, you really need to be able to see where they're gonna go so that your actions can get you on arc every turn. This is a kind of a
tough spot for Vader. Looks like he's just going for a target lock evade.
Well, I mean, you really got to consider those actions. He's got one hull. If anything gets through, that's a problem. It's actually why I like Juke on Vader.
Yeah.
Because every time you take that defensive action, that evade, you're actually getting offensive work out of it.
That's something I haven't tried enough of yet.
Yeah, Juke's become one of my favorite of the new cards that have come out recently.
I like it with the comms relay that we get in the TIE FO pack, but I'm not sure if it's worth the 5 points for the combo.
Yeah, but I still think it's a great card just to have anyways. I mean, I'm not sure it's great with the FOs. But especially with Vader, you're doing an action to it's going to keep him alive longer, which is good for you. With ATC or Accuracy Corrector, you've already got some guaranteed damage results, at least. So taking the defensive action doesn't hurt you as much, and then that defensive action is having real offensive dividends to pay in, which I think is great.
Vader narrowly staying alive that last turn.
Some lucky Ron and some good decision-making with that evade.
Pro barrel roll, the arc dodge.
Yeah.
Still being able to get another action. Real tough choice. What do you do here? It all depends on where Jake's gonna go. Take a focus, try and murder Poe, or take an evade token, try and play it safe.
I think you almost always want to go play it safe with someone like this in this situation. I mean, I don't know. It is a tough decision.
Yep. I mean, a little bit of a mistake here. That early on bump with Sheeran, it really threw off the geometry on Jake. I mean, just that little bit of an angle change. I was really hoping I could get into range one of Vader there. I think I'd certainly have it if I would have barrel rolled off of the focus and then pushed for a boost. But that early bump, just throwing off the angles just enough to keep Vader out of line of sight.
Yeah, that's a real boon for Vader. He really likes not being shot at right now, and this is a clutch moment for him.
Yep, so Jake just takes the target lock instead. Poe getting two shields out. He'll still be getting one back again.
Yeah, I mean, that's another great thing about the regenerating ships is you really have to consider that the next round they're going to have one health. Like, even if you get them down to one health, they're going to get one back, so it's always two, you know?
Yeah, and they're slow enough against most Imperialists. They can outslow most Imperialists, so it's really hard to keep pressure on them for an extended amount of time.
Yeah, I mean, in this situation, a one forward may well have gotten Poe out of any possible arc from Vader. I mean, and could have meant that no shots on Vader, or no shots from Vader, rather, this turn.
Yeah. I think at this point, I just wanted to keep Poe kind of out in the open, see how long he can last, and wait for Jake to come up and sweep in.
I think that's a good move. I mean, keeping Poe alive is important and good, and I think a lot of players would do that. But now, Poe is a great bait. Poe is perfect bait, because Vader's going to go for him because he's the weakest ship, and you can kind of capitalize on that.
Yeah. As long as he can stay alive. Looks like he gets all of his shields out and regenning one, so he's down to one shield and one hull.
Poe is super durable when his ability's up defensively, so it's a good move. It's hard to kill Poe at the best of times.
Yeah.
Here we see a little bit of a sad Vader having to use his second action to barrel roll in order to get arc instead of taking a focus or an evade.
Yep.
Because here comes Jake.
Jake at range 3, probably, it looks like, and a quick boost in a barrel roll with the focus.
Yeah, that's so efficient.
Getting into range 1.
I mean, at range 1, Jake is... he's a very effective, very damaging ship. It's really just the range 2 and 3 where I hear people complain about his offensive ability.
Yeah. Got 3 in on Poe. He needs a couple symbols here. And just not enough. Goodbye, so Vader finally taking out Poe.
But now he is a sitting duck for the avenging Jake.
Yep.
And it does not take much to take out Vader right now.
Yeah. That A-Wing for the clutch. I think the MVP is that asteroid. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. And be sure to leave a comment below with a list that you'd like to see us run.